Hello and welcome. I'm Brian with TanyourNomad.com, and today we'll be looking at the history of Muse Software. Muse was an early game developer, probably best known for games like Castle Wolfenstein, Space Taxi, and Robot War. Even if you're not familiar with those titles, you probably have heard of Wolfenstein 3D, the seminal first-person shooter by id Software. Although that game has virtually nothing to do with Muse, the guys at id were big fans of Castle Wolfenstein, so they borrowed the title for their game. So coming back to the history of Muse, I guess we should start back in 1949, when future Muse co-founder Silas Warner was born in Chicago, Illinois. After Silas's father attempted to kill him and his mother when he was 7, the family fled south to Bloomington, and Silas never saw his father again. Silas was a gifted, well-spoken child and scored a perfect SAT score in high school. As an adult, he stood 6'9" and weighed over 300 pounds, so not your typical geek. After graduating from Indiana University's physics program, he soon had an opportunity to work with the latest version of the Plato system. Plato ran on a huge CDC mainframe connected to thousands of graphics terminals around the country and was built by the University of Illinois. It was intended to be an instructional system, but naturally became the host to some of the earliest graphical computer games, many with multiplayer support, such as Air Race, a flight shooter capable of hosting up to 50 players at a time. In 1978, Silas bought his first personal computer, the Apple II, serial number 234. He met two other coworkers who were also early Apple II adopters, Ed Zarin, a fellow programmer, and Jim Black, an accountant. The first games they produced were Maze Game and Tank War. After selling huge quantities of these games at the Trenton Computer Festival, Muse was officially born. You can see back then, Muse was an acronym, short for Micro Users Software Exchange. What's interesting about these early tapes is that the color of the paper seems to be somewhat random. I'm thinking they just got any color they currently had available to them. Even the font's a little bit different on some of these. Jim's girlfriend at the time happened to be an artist, and so you can thank her for all this lovely artwork you see on these early tapes. Thanks, Jim's girlfriend! Tucked away in these tapes, you'd often find some brief instructions or even foldable manuals. Here's some gameplay of Escape. It's a follow-up to Silas's earlier Maze game. Most of these early games were written in WASD's Integer Basic and were quite primitive, but Escape is somewhat ambitious using 3D mazes and a first-person perspective. The object here is simply to get out of the maze. You'll encounter guards and other people who can give you certain items and clues, but some of them will try to stop you if you don't have a pass. The guys that do help you are not always as helpful as they might be. This game has a bit of historical significance, as it was the game that Richard Garriott played that inspired him to put 3D dungeons in Akalabeth, and thus the early Ultima games. One of the titles that really jump-started Muse's popularity was Robot War, which was based on a Plato game of the same name that Silas had made years earlier. The game allowed you to assemble robots using the provided programming language and watch them duke it out in an arena. Computer Gaming World held annual contests for this game where readers could send in their robots on a disc and they would fight each other in a match. And then there was Castle Wolfenstein. Inspired by the gaming mechanics of Robotron and the movie The Guns of Navarone, Silas wrote a new game about breaking out of a heavily guarded Nazi prison. Inspired by Bob Bishop's Apple Talker, Silas designed a new sound engine called The Voice that allowed the guards to actually yell in audible speech. Best of all, it was in German. The game had many strategic elements not often seen at the time, like the ability to search dead bodies, and to think before you shoot somebody, as strategy plays a big part. Muse didn't develop all of their own games, they actually published a few titles, including this one, called The Caverns of Freitag. The creator David Shapiro, aka Dr. Cat, would go on to work at Origin and help on multiple Ultima titles. This game is basically a dungeon crawler, with a few RPG elements thrown in. There are three different modes of play, including this mode, as well as a text and bird's eye view. There's multiple weapons to be found, and after killing a certain number of enemies, you'll want to return home to level up. The monsters are randomly plotted when you play the game, so sometimes you'll have it easy, and other times you'll spawn with several enemies around you, ready to commence gang raping. One of the later titles to come out of Muse was Space Taxi for the Commodore 64, best described as 8-bit Crazy Taxi meets Lunar Lander. It was unique for the featured sample speech at the time, as well as its clever, quirky level design. The game offers a lot of charm. Muse had several other titles to their name before shutting their doors in 1985. It's a shame that they were such a short-lived company and that Silas passed away in 2004. But their games live on, and so does their legacy. Thank you for watching.